Welcome back. So we just entered Death Valley National Park on California Highway 178, west of Shoshone, California. And this is going to be a long video driving all the way through the park. So I was going to go to the racetrack, but because I can't tent camp on this trip, I will save that for next time I come down. sure stopping at Badwater because it's full of water, and maybe we'll see some people kayaking there. Doesn't happen very often. Elevation 3,315 feet. And we should be able to see into the Badwater Basin soon. So that's what we are going down into. Then we're gonna head north. Places on Earth, the lowest in North America. I think it's in the top five for lowest places. So the two slices of pizza at Maverick were only like $6 after tax. If you're traveling, you can eat really cheap at Maverick and get hot food. They got great burgers, breakfast burritos. They got it all. Coffee's good. Outside of Bucky's, there's no better gas station chain I can think of for breakfast. Wow, road subject to flooding next 55 miles. Color, brown color that I've never seen before. I like it. Jubilee Pass, elevation 1,293 feet. Look at the yellow flowers. Way cool. I'm not sure I've ever done this road.
Parking lot is packed all morning long. In a quarter mile, Turn right onto Badwater Road.
So normally, we come in from the south, from Baker. So I mean, that's why I don't think I have ever done this road.
Turn right onto Badwater Road.
Actually, maybe not, because that's a dirt road. I would like to do it someday. Yeah, so I guess we have done that road before. We are on Badwater Road now, going north. West Side Road, you can only drive it in the this summer, I believe. It's probably underwater now. I'm pretty sure. I could be wrong. It, that would be fun to do someday. start to see the Badwater temporary lake soon. I'll be around this corner. First long trip since I broke my ankle and had surgery, and pretty happy with how I feel. Just hope it keeps getting better. It was so depressing when I couldn't drive and realized I wasn't going on a trip anytime soon. Basically, I didn't bring my tent because I didn't think it was worth lugging around. If I would have had it, I could have camped last night and tonight, I guess. I don't know. I guess that would have been worth it. It's alright, though. I kind of happy to be home, and I'm glad I'm keeping this trip to 1 week or less. Because I want to go back out in May. Thank you. wonder if the water levels already went down. They said it doesn't last for more than a few weeks or a month, maybe. it's just rock. Not much on the left either. There's a few bushes on the left. definitely got more water than it does in the summer, I will say that. that hike. Wow, we have a full-blown lake here. It is true. Look at that. No more white. It is water. Wow. That is so cool. Wow. I am amazed. You can still kayak in there, it looks like. There's a kayaker right there on top of the car. I wonder if they're gonna take their kayak out. So there's REI Co-op. They're having a, it looks like they're sponsoring a trip there for bikers. That's pretty cool. Here comes some bikers right now. I don't know if they're racing or if it's just for fun. That's pretty cool though. Headed north again on Badwater Road, Furnace Creek, next stop. I don't actually think I will stop there because I don't need to buy anything and I really do want to get as close to home as possible today. I had to remind myself the last few days, the whole point of this trip is to get driving video because I have none to put up. To the right, it's a dirt gravel road full of washboards, and there's an RV going up it. The hiking trail is awesome, but it just rattles everything for like 3 miles, and you're going 5 to 10 miles per hour. I would not take an RV on that road ever again if we ever had one. But I wanted to do that hike, and we had our cat with us. It must be pretty rough right now after all the rain, because they're just crawling. Oh, so there was an event from Shoshone to Baker. I wonder if this is some type of bike race, endurance thing. That's the event, I bet. And it goes through Death Valley also. Wow, that's pretty cool. Imagine kayaking to the other side of the lake. It's like 5 to 10 miles. At least 5. I want to say 10, but 5. It might be 5 miles to the other side from Badwater. 35 degrees and 9:15 in the morning.
We're gonna
to be in the snow this afternoon, which is hard to believe. Oh, so up here on the right, there's a big trailhead parking lot. And you can do a loop hike. We did that once. It was really fun. There's one point where you gotta kind of climb up some rocks in a wash. That was a lot of fun. Unfortunately, I was not YouTubing at the time. It's called Golden Canyon. Down the wash during the flood. They used to be by the road, like road barricades.
That is crazy.
I think I see a dumpster even. Doing construction. Come on, car, please go. Why are you so? Level right now. Yeah, straight in front of us is Furnace Creek. Oh, it's such an oasis. There's a golf course there, if I remember right. So for me to stay here, I want to say it was $250, $350 right now a night, and I did not want to pay that much. Plus it was dark, so I didn't want to drive in the dark here. It would be neat to stay there sometime, though. I just don't think it ever gets cheaper than that. That's too much money. And I thought that you used to have cell service here, and I'm not sure you do. This is Furnace Creek, elevation minus 190 feet. And right to the left here is the little gift shop slash food place you can stop and get some food. It's called the Ranch at Death Valley. Way cool place. I will camp here someday. $7.88 for diesel.
Jeez.
So they have RV spots right here, and they have power. But there's the visitor center, and the visitor center is where the campground is for tents. I have a video where I drove through that. Wow, sun is out. Furnace Creek Campground. It is full. It is 66 degrees though. Even though I'm not stopping on this trip, hopefully when I name the places we drive by, it gives you an idea of how many things are along this road, and there's not really a lot, honestly. It's still fun. It's still worth coming to. And if you want to see like 115, 120 degrees, come here in the summer. It's like an oven. Highway 190 right now. dehydrated this morning. First time on the trip. Should have 60 to 70 hours of driving video by the time I get home from 5 days of driving. Actually, 6 days of driving. Today is day four. Probably have 2 more days. This my California winter 2024 trip. It was by far the highlight. turnoff coming up. I don't know if it's a gravel road or if it's the highway going to Scotty's Castle. Sky. So I leave and we have sun for 3 days, and when I get back home starting this weekend, it's raining for like 5 days straight. I couldn't believe it when I saw that. Is that road back there to Beatty? I don't think went to Scotty's Castle. I think the Scotty's Castle Road is coming up. Oh, they basically go to the same place. So maybe they both go to Scotty's Castle. Yeah. Bishop, California. I thought I had service, but I don't.
Please say address, place of interest, intersection.
Bishop, Main Street, California.
Please say the address.
Main Street, Bishop, California.
Okay, searching for Main Street, Bishop, California. I'm finding more than one match. Please select manually from the display.
Wow, 2 hours and 22 minutes to Bishop. It'll be 12:30.
Guidance will start now. Proceed 83 miles on California 190.
AC vent for like 2 minutes, but we are off. It's actually attached to the back door. I don't know if I've ever seen that before. It's really
neat. 600 feet, turn right.
It's a heat pump, I think.
In 400 feet, turn right to California 190.
Yeah, the battery.
Right to California 190.
The little GoPro batteries get so hot that they actually start bulging. could see it, you know, getting deformed when you take it, when you get it out finally, but you can't pull it out when it's hot because it's pressing against the internal sides of the camera. It's, I'm just waiting for it to like catch on fire one day. Usually the camera will turn off and say too hot if it gets too hot. But that's why I do not keep the batteries in when I'm driving. But I forgot to take it out that time. But, crisis averted. We're good to go. We are coming up upon Stovepipe. Feels like a stovepipe in the summer. Station here, you can buy your park pass if you don't have one and get info and everything. Stovepipe Wells, elevation 5 feet. It's a cool place, but there's the ranger station on the right. It's little, but it's still fun. Elevation sea level. So they have a little RV park right there, and AT&T works. And Verizon might work here too. So this place, the lodge here, I could have stayed here for $179 a night, but there was a two-night minimum. And I'm confused as to whether that was for that price or two-night minimum regardless, so I didn't even try to stay here. I don't want to stay here 2 days. Wow, there's a trailhead right there to the left, 2 miles up that road. We never did that one. It's like a canyon. So, turn off AC the next 20 miles. We're going to go uphill. ride this pass is 4,000 feet. like when I was actually camping that one time 2 years ago, it was better because I was around people. I think that's what it is. Like, I miss home, but also I miss just being around my wife and our cat. Like, you just get lonely when you travel this way, staying in hotels, not really interacting with anyone. I told my wife, I said, my neighbor, like, saw my maps and, like, said, oh, I would love to do stuff like that, but she didn't want to do it alone, because she's old, 75, and I said, oh, she could travel with me, we could split gas and everything, and get our own hotel room, if, you know, but then I was like, oh, she might want to talk, and she'd be on YouTube then, so I don't know if that would work. Up here, 20 degrees colder than Death Valley. Brick check, 1.5 mile. Oh no, 1/8. This is just amazing up here. 47 degrees at the top. So it's called Town Pass, elevation 4,956 feet. So we're almost 5,000 feet up. That's pretty incredible. Alright, now we gotta have to pass this guy, it looks like. If I can. Oh, that's a pickup pulling a Jeep. Why would you do that? This is really pretty, I think. car trailer over this mountain. This is like the steepest mountain pass road I think that I've been on in the entire country. It's probably, I want to say it's like 10, 12% grade, and it's for 10 or 15 miles. It's not, you know, 3 or 4 miles. It's a long way. Not even halfway down yet. go left here, you can go to Trona, California, which is like kind of a semi-abandoned old mining town. And the road is, I think it's rough in places. Because it gets washed out. One of these days I might do it. All the YouTubers go there though. So you can find it on YouTube. So I drove through this campground last time I came through here. If you want to see it, Google Panamint Springs, I believe. Or Death Valley. Oh, you know what? I'm not sure I put that up because that was when I had the finger smudge. So, yeah, I'll have to check and see if I actually do have the video of that. Alright, we are going in the canyon. So this is only the second time ever I've done this section of road. Feet. So basically, the bottom of that valley might have only been 1,000 feet. We weren't as low as I thought. 3,000 feet. So the planes that fly here, I think they come from China Lake, and they do their testing in the area. I can't remember the name of this canyon. Hopefully there's a sign. So straight in front of us to the right, they come over that ridge really low. I knew how often they came up here. Wow, I didn't realize that viewpoint was toward the top. I thought it was more in the middle. We still haven't got to it yet. It's Father Crowley Vista Point. We're 4,000 feet. And I am not going to stop here. There's no planes flying today. If you got time to kill, you could sit there for hours hoping they come up over that ridge and fly down the canyon. And I don't know why they do it, if it's just for fun. Or to put on a show they know people watch. I don't know. But it's, look up Father Crowley Canyon planes or something like that. And you'll have videos come up of, it's military planes like F-18s and stuff. And they'll be flying really low over that ridge across the canyon, and then they fly, I thought they flew down into the canyon. That part I don't know. I could be making that up. I just know when I go over the parking lot, they're really low and it's loud. But it is 51 degrees back there. Kinda chilly. Yeah, so the planes come really low here, right over down by that canyon. So if they were here, we would see them in front of us right now. Thanks for watching.